Number three, Zach Barron. Second baseman, number two, Will Redding. The first baseman, number seven, Jared Jones. Doing the catching today in game one, number 34, Zach Jones. And on the mound for GSW, making his seventh appearance, all starts. Junior right-hander, number 33, Kyle Spinks.
Yours could be a little bit louder. That's yours right there. Yep. And good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We are live from Americus, Georgia, this afternoon's Peach Belt Conference.
Orlando University.
Doubleheader action featuring the visiting Bearcats from Lander University. Taking on your Georgia Southwestern State University Hurricanes. We're glad you could join us here on what's a overcast day in Americus. Looks dark behind us. We'll hopefully dry. A dry field and a dry afternoon. Hopefully you'll stick with us. First pitch of the ball game.
Now batting the second baseman, number one.
Alec Dowell is a ground ball through the left side. Goes for a single, so one pitch, one hit. The Lander Bearcats with their first runner and first batter of the game reaching base. So we're just underway from Hurricane Stadium. Here in Americus, thank you for once again tuning in to this afternoon's Peach Belt Conference game, the Bearcats and the Hurricanes. Two evenly matched teams if you just go based on record. Both squads come into today's doubleheader with a record of 10 and 13 overall, and both are 4-5 in Peach Belt Conference play. So an important series for both teams. Doubleheader again today with the series finale tomorrow afternoon at 1 o'clock. I mentioned, for those of you just tuning in or might have missed it, one pitch, one hit for Lander to kick things off in this ball game. Alec Dowell, the center fielder for the Bearcats, a ground ball through the left side on the first pitch he saw from Kyle Spinks, puts a runner on board. Now the second batter for Lander is the second baseman, number one, Colton Yeager. Yeager, after a throw over to first base, Yeager swung at the next pitch and has since fouled off to maintain an 0-2 count. So Spinks ahead 0-2 to Colton Yeager, number one. Again, the Bearcats second baseman. Spinks will throw over to first base again to keep the runner honest. He's back easily and safely. Colton Yeager, of the players on the roster that have started almost or just about every game this season, Yeager's got the leading batting average on the club, a 318 hitter. That pitch, a ball to Yeager, 318. Five doubles, a home run, 10 RBIs, seven walks, 20 strikeouts in 22 games. So he's up there swinging as he did early in this at bat, and now he's managed to lay off the last two pitches to run the count to 2-2. Two-two pitch, foul back off the back screen. Count remains 2-2.
Hey,
Another throw over to first base. Dowell back in safely. Another 2-2 pitch coming to Yeager from Kyle Spinks. That one in on the hands, a chopper to first base. Jared Jones has it, calls off the pitcher, goes over and steps on the bag for the first out of the inning.
Now batting the left fielder, number 24, Alex Conaway.
So Dowell able to make his way over to second on the slow chopper to the first baseman. One away now for the Bearcats in the first. The batter's a right-handed hitter, number 24. The left fielder, Alex Conaway. Conaway batting 253 this season. Four doubles, three triples, nine RBIs, 11 walks, 24 strikeouts in 23 games. And Conaway on to face Spinks. Spinks keeping a close eye on the runner at second. Now he comes out and bounces into home. Good cover by the catcher to keep it in front of him. Ball one. So Spinks comes into today's ball game. The weekend ace of the pitching staff getting the game one call. 1-2 record overall. This is his seventh start. The 1-1 pitch, big cut, swing and a miss. 1-1. 34 and a third innings pitch, 29 hits, 11 earned runs, 16 walks, 28 strikeouts for a 2.88 ERA. Opponents are batting 223 against Spinks. That one foul tip. 1-3. I think so. So lots of action on campus here this afternoon. We've got our baseball doubleheader going on right behind us. The Lady Hurricanes tennis team is in action, taking on Albany State. And then over across the parking lot is the softball complex where the Lady Hurricanes are home today to host Augusta in Peach Belt Conference play. 1-2 pitch, that ball's up high, 2-2. So lots of activity, although it's the closing weekend of spring break on campus, so students most likely not trickling back into town until tomorrow. Check swing foul ball over the, softly over the Lander dugout, which is on the first base side here at Hurricane Stadium. The Bearcats wearing their royal blue or blue Lander blue pullovers, pullover tops, yellow and white trim, yellow numbers with white trim, gray pants with a blue stripe down the side. The 2-2 pitch also foul tip. So the Lander batters have been forcing Spinks to throw quite a few pitches in the early going. This only the third batter of the game, and he's had to throw 14 pitches already. Count remains 2-2 to Alex Conaway, the left fielder. GSW wearing their Vegas gold tops today in game one. Navy blue numbers, white trim, canes across the chest, white pants. No piping. Popped up. Foul out of play, first base side. Count remains 2-2. Got their blue caps with the gold bills. And the GSW logo up on top. So there you go. Wind blowing in today. So we're already it's already a big yard here, over 400 to straightaway center. 330 down the lines. Swing and a miss. Pitch goes in the dirt. They'll throw down to first base. Get him. Now the runner will take off for third on the throw down to first.
Now batting the first baseman, number 18, Nathan Schreckengast.
Okay. Dowell moves over to third. He broke for third base on the throw down to first. This one a chopper, first pitch to Jones over at first. He stayed busy, he takes a couple steps in, touches the bag for the final out of the inning.
One hit, no GSW errors. There was one runner left on base.
So a couple of one pitch outs were needed by Spinks in the first after a couple of the middle two batters ran him weary with several foul balls. So ground out to first to end the inning, and Lander in the first, no runs, a hit. There were no errors and they left a runner on base. We'll take a look at the Hurricanes batting order here in our opener, first leading off. And for those of you that have followed the Hurricanes all season long, you won't see maybe two shifts from the usual. One shift here is, we'll run down the order. Alex Kranick will lead off, the third baseman. Number 22, Alex coming in with a team leading 13 game hitting streak. So we hope he has a good weekend and keep that thing rolling. 13 game hitting streak for Kranick coming into the weekend. Batting second, center fielder, number 23, Evan Alderman. Batting third, second baseman, Will Redding. Number two. In the cleanup spot is the first baseman, number seven, Jared Jones. Batting fifth, shortstop, number three, Zach Barron. Batting sixth, the designated hitter, Josh Logan, number 15. Batting seventh is number 20, the left fielder, Jonathan Martin. Batting eighth and playing right field, number 24, Clay Patrick. Batting ninth and catching here in game one of the series is number 34, Zach Jones. Facing Spinks on the other side for Lander here this afternoon, making his sixth start of the season. He's got a 1-1 record, 27 and two-thirds innings pitched. 25 hits, 7 earned runs, 11 walks, 34 strikeouts over 27 and two-thirds innings, a 2.28 ERA. It's number 11. I'm sorry, I read you the wrong information. There's another JD. How about we go back? JD Waite is the starting pitcher, number 8. This is his fifth start. 17 innings pitched, 25 hits, 14 earned runs, 2 walks, 9 strikeouts, a 7.41 ERA for number 8, JD Waite. Opponents batting 338 against Mr. Waite. So I'm sorry, a couple of JDs. This is JD Waite making the start today. Left-handed hurler for the Bearcats. He'll face again the third baseman, number 22, Alex Kranick. First pitch to Kranick, in there for a strike. That pitch bounces into home plate, 1-1. Got a good crowd online today listening to Georgia Southwestern Baseball and Lander University, our opponent. Thanks for tuning in. And that's game number 14. Alex Kranick just extended his hitting streak. Ground ball up the middle for a single. Congratulations to Alex. And just like that, pressure's off, at least for game number 14. So with the 1-1 count, Kranick hits a ground ball up the middle and has extended his hitting streak to 14 games. That'll bring up a left-handed batter. Oh, 40. Left-handed batter, center fielder Evan Alderman. That pitch sails outside. Lefty on lefty matchup. So Alderman has brought, squares to bunt, pulls back, fastball in there for a strike. 1-1.
GSW only. You'll have to stay back soon. Especially with your Under Armour stuff on.
Chopper by Alderman. It's going to be a tough play. It scoots under the second baseman's glove. It was a high chopper. He was waiting to get it when it comes down. Kranick motors all the way around to third, and there's runners on the corners.
Now batting the second baseman, number two, Will Redding.
I think. So that was a tough play by the second baseman, a big chopper that he had to wait forever for it to come down. And he was already going back to cover first base on a bunt attempt, so he had to slide back towards second base, wait for it to come down. It went under his glove. Didn't even get a mitt on it and into the outfield. First pitch to Will Redding has popped up short center field. Wind keeps blowing. Has to make a diving attempt. And we got to wait and see. The center fielder from Lander is down, writhing in pain. He went full out stretch, made the catch. Tagging up from third is Kranick. But the center fielder's rolling from side to side, kind of, now he's up, thankfully, but doesn't look like he really wants the coach to come out as he's walking away from the coach who's coming out to check on him.
It is.
Rolling the shoulder over a few times, it's his left shoulder. It was a heck of a catch by the center fielder, fully extended. The wind, as I mentioned, was blowing in, so that shallow fly ball made it even more difficult with the aid of the wind. Comes in, fully extended, completely off the ground on that dive, catches the ball. Kranick patiently waits at third and tags up. So Redding will get an RBI, and they're checking on the center fielder, Alec Dowell.
We need a Dr. Lucas Bianco at the medical minute.
Yeah.
Yeah, where's he at? Is he here this week? He's spring breaking. Picking up some chicks down. No, he's here. He was here yesterday.
So first pitch for Redding. Alderman stays over at first. Kranick will score. There's one away. And they're still meeting out there in center field. Teammates and the coach out there to check on them. So he's definitely the left shoulder. He kind of keeps, you know, swimmer stroke with it, rolling it over to check to make sure. So as it looks like they're breaking up in center field, coach is hustling back to the dugout. And thankfully, Alec is going to stay out in center field. So glad to see that he's able to keep going. So Alec Dowell will stay in the game at center field.
Now batting the first baseman, number seven, Jared Jones.
So we're the cleanup man in the batting order for the Hurricanes. The first baseman, number seven, Jared Jones. Right-handed batter, Jared Jones. Jones. 316 batting average for the first baseman. First pitch off the plate away from the right-handed batter. Jared Jones. Three doubles. He leads the team with 18 RBIs. Throw over to first base. Runner stands up, back safely. Eight walks, 17 strikeouts. He's been also plunked a team leading five times. This one bounces into home. They'll throw down to first. Head first slide by Alderman. He's back in time. I like standing. Maybe we'll just hit him out. I got some major problems. 2-0 pitch to Jones, ground ball to the third baseman. He spears it out of the air, throws over to second. For one, over to first. And the throw pulls the runner off the bag, so a fielder's choice. They got the runner at second base.
Now batting the shortstop, number 3, Zach Barron.
So Alderman is forced out 5-4. Jones reaches on a fielder's choice. So the still runner at first base for the Hurricanes. Two away now for the Hurricanes and Zach Barron, 241 hitter. Four home runs, leads the Hurricanes, 16 RBIs. First pitch to Barron is a ball. One-0 pitch, big cut, swing and a miss. Also a reminder, fans, for those of you tuned in, we're 1-1 pitch first, foul third base side, pulled it down third base side behind the coach's box over there at third. 1-2 now will be the count to Zach Barron. Two away in the first, Hurricanes pushing the run across, lead Lander early, 1-0. But there are video. We are recording today's broadcast, but it'll have to be uploaded after the doubleheader, the 1-2 pitch off the plate away from the right-handed batter. So we are recording our doubleheader this afternoon, and we'll be loading it up to YouTube this evening so you can watch a replay of it. Tape delay, as they would say in the old days. Two balls, two strikes, off-speed pitch, ground ball through the left side, base hit for Zach Barron, a two-out single through the hole between third and short.
Now batting the designated hitter, number 15, Josh Logan.
So it's good to see the Hurricanes bats coming alive early in this one. The team all around has been heating up as of late. The Hurricanes showing some signs here of the bats coming around. First pitch to the designated hitter, Josh Logan, is taken for a strike. Josh Logan, 279 batter, making his 12th start of the season. The 0-1 pitch, chopped down off his ankle. Logan kind of gingerly shaking out the left foot. Right-handed batter. Now staring down an 0-2 count. Logan batting again, 279, 5 RBIs. Yet to walk this season, and he struck out 9 times. And 43 at bat. So Logan steps in. 0-2 count, two away in the first. Hurricanes with a 1-0 lead. That pitch bounces into home, blocked by the catcher. Dude, he's got to have him dead for rights at third base. And they'll gun him down. That pitch smothered quickly by the catcher. Good work, and they'll get Jones easily. They were waiting for him at third base, so a good play to end the inning for the Bearcats. We'll be back in a moment. The Hurricanes, 3 hits in the first to go with 1 run. We'll see you in a moment. Back for the second inning in just a moment from Hurricane Stadium.
Leading off the top of the
And we're back for the second inning.
The right fielder, number 21, Carson Jones.
Lead off batter for Lander here in the second. Right fielder number 21, Carson Jones. Right-handed batter on to face Spinks here in the second inning. Carson Jones leading the Bearcats in a couple of categories offensively. Batting 263, the first pitch of ball. But Carson Jones leads the team with 7 doubles. And he also leads the squad with 19 RBIs. That pitch also a ball, 2-0. 263 batting average, as I mentioned. 4 walks. And now he has only been walked 4 times this year. And he's very aggressive at the plate. 34 strikeouts. That pitch taken for a strike, a 3-0 pitch. So Jones with a good bat. And he's aggressive at the plate, likes to go after. This one a ground ball to the shortstop. Fielded cleanly and thrown to first base. It drops out of the first baseman's mitt. So that'll be an error on the first baseman. He had it right in his glove as he did have to stretch for it.
Hitter number 3, Reed Gray.
So Reed Gray will step in. Routine ground ball there, fielded cleanly by the shortstop. The throw did draw a stretch from Jones, but straight towards throw over, diving head first in safely is Jones. He didn't have to scoop it off the ground. It was down there by his ankles as he was leaning, stretching to short, and it just fell out. So on board, another throw, draws another head first dive. Jones in safely. Jones. One stolen base this season. Reed Gray is the designated hitter. He's at the plate, a right-hander to face Spinks. First pitch taken for a strike. Reed Gray. Now he leads the team with a .500 batting average, but he had missed some games early on in the season. Batting .500, but this is his 14th start and the 24th game of the year for the Bearcats, so he's missed 10 of their 24 games. That pitch called strike, outer edge of the plate away from the right-handed batter, 0-2. 500 batting average, 4 doubles in that time, a triple, 2 home runs, and 8 ribbies. So he's definitely another strong bat in the Lander batting order. Ground ball, this will go through the left side between third and short for a base hit. Building on that average.
Now batting the shortstop number 6, Bailey Connell.
So Lander has 2 men aboard and nobody out. Runner at second is Jones. Runner at first is Gray, the batter, the shortstop. Number 6, Bailey Connell. So the Bearcats have a little something going early on. Both sides, again, have been making contact off both starting pitchers today. First pitch, high for a ball. And again, for those of you that may have an interest, live stats are available for today's ballgame, so you can listen to the action, spin and throw to second base, diving in safely. Got the mitt down on the hand, but the hand for Carson Jones was on the bag. 1-0 the count. Bailey Connell. Connell, the number 7 hitter in the Bearcats batting order here in game number 1. Infield in at the corners. There's the bunt. It's going to be trouble. It's a good bunt. Third baseman Kranick has to come over. That bunt right towards the shorts where the shortstop would normally be. Had a little pace on it. Excellent bunt. Bunt single because Kranick slides over. He's protecting the line.
Mason Dodd.
He picks the ball up behind, well, towards short, but past the pitcher's mound. Throw is late. Bunt single. And the bases are loaded with nobody out. That'll draw a visit to the mound. So Coach McLean is going to want to come up and talk to his defense. Glander has the bases loaded in the second. Nobody out. Mason Dodd will be the batter when we return here. We'll be back. We're going to take a quick break. We'll be back in a moment listening to Georgia Southwestern State University Baseball right here on Surges Sports Network. So the meeting at the mound has come to an end, and now we're ready to resume action. First pitch, swing and a miss. Left-handed batter, Mason Dodd, the third baseman. Now facing an 0-1 count. Lander, three hits in the game, two this inning. That pitch, did he go? The appeal, base ump says nope, did not offer. So must have missed just outside, ball one, 1-1. Hurricanes had three hits in the first, came away with one run. Big swing and a miss. So Spiggs might have to at least get this first one on his own. And then he can maybe help, get a little help from the defense to end the inning. That would be huge, but still got work to do against Mason Dodd. Time called by the batter. He'll step out of the box. Back in, and he is on top of the plate. Foul ball over the GSW dugout on the third base side. Count remains 1-2. Yes, sir. Inside cornered. Dodd hand on his hip. He'll go back to the dugout.
The catcher number 15, Ryan Troutman.
I was just going to say it's a gutsy play to try to go inside with him on top the plate. But if the umpire is willing to give you a little bit on the corner on the inside, the potential's there because there's no room for his arms to come through on that pitch. And they get the strikeout looking. So a strikeout, big strikeout, one away in the second. And now the catcher, Ryan Troutman, steps in. Troutman batting 244. He's got a couple of home runs, eight RBIs. First pitch, a ground ball to the second baseman. Flicks it underhand to the shortstop. Now over to first, double play, the Hurricanes. And Spinks get out of the second with no runs.
Lander in the top of the second. No runs, two hits. There was one GSW error, two runners left on base.
First pitch swinging, 4-6, three.
Lander, nothing.
Big double play.
Weekend Warriors, baby, that's what I'm talking about.
For Lander in the second, no runs, two hits, an error. There were two runners left on base. Spinks works his way out of a bases loaded, no out jam. We'll be back for the bottom of the second in just a moment here on Surges Sports Network, your home for Georgia Southwestern State University Baseball. So we head to the bottom of the second inning. Hurricanes. First batter will remain Josh Logan. Logan was at the plate when they gunned down Jones at third. First pitch, swinging strike. Second pitch popped up. Will it stay in play? Catcher's moving over in front of the GSW dugout. Third baseman calls him off, and he'll make the catch right in front of the Hurricanes.
Now batting the left fielder, number 20, Jonathan Martin.
So one out. The batter will be left fielder, number 20, Jonathan Martin. So stepping into the box, the left fielder. Left-handed batter, number 20, Jonathan Martin. First pitch up high. Martin, the reigning Peach Belt Conference Freshman of the Week. That pitch also a little bit upstairs, ball two. So for the Hurricanes, back-to-back weekly Peach Belt honors. 2 weeks ago, it was this pitch popped up on the infield again. Catcher's moving over. Wind might blow that one back in a little bit towards him, and he'll make the play. So another pop-up in foul territory.
34, Zach Jones.
Nope, Clay Patrick. Right fielder Clay Patrick makes his way in. So as I was mentioning, the Hurricanes back-to-back weeks with a Peach Belt weekly honor. 2 weeks ago, it was pitcher Dylan Brown earning the Pitcher of the Week. And then this past week, it was Jonathan Martin picking up a Freshman of the Week honor. So some accolades in the early going for GSW. First pitch to Clay Patrick, the right fielder. Up and past the catcher to the backstop. Ball one. Two away for the Hurricanes in the second. Bases are empty. We're at the number 8 spot in the batting order. Clay Patrick. This one he turns on just a little bit too much, a couple feet left of the third base line, so foul ball. Patrick batting 141. One home run, actually got that in the opening series of the season. Six RBIs. That pitch catches the outside corner. Right-handed batter for a strike. 1-2. Four walks, 12 strikeouts. This is 65th at bat. Off-speed pitch, chopper. This is going to be trouble. Over the pitcher's head, second baseman's charging. He's not going to get there in time. And it'll be an infield single for Clay Patrick.
The catcher, number 34, Zach Jones.
And now the catcher, Zach Jones, steps in. Zach Jones making it. This was only his third start of the spring. Jones, a freshman from Milton, Georgia. Went to North Paulding High School. First pitch to Jones is a ball. Oops. So Jones, the freshman, getting the call here on a Peach Belt weekend. This is a line drive to left field. It's going to one hop to the left fielder. A base hit and his first collegiate single. Base hit for Zach Jones. Congratulations to Zach for his first collegiate hit.
Kranick.
Patrick will advance to second. I hadn't even got that far, but Jones was 0 for 8 coming in. And he takes that pitch. The 1-0 pitch into left field, solid single. And again, congratulations, Zach Jones, his first collegiate hit. Two away, runners on first and second. We're back to the top of the order, and Alex Kranick, who led off the game with a single up the middle. First pitch to Kranick. Misses, perhaps just a little bit low for a ball. Runners at first and second, two away. Patrick's at second, Zach Jones at first. Alex Kranick, line drive. That's gonna fall inside the third baseline. This is extra bases. Coming around to score is Patrick. Moving over to third is the catcher, Zach Jones, and it's a stand-up double for the Hurricanes' leading batter, Alex Kranick.
Now batting the center fielder, number 23, Evan Alderman.
So that line drive just got over the third baseman's head as he jumped up in the air, fully extended above his head, reaching, and landed in the short left field, right inside the third base line. Hurricanes with two runners in scoring position and a two-out rally here to give themselves a 2-0 lead in the second. First pitch to Kranick up high for a ball. So let's see if the senior and left-handed batter, Evan Alderman, can really put the Hurricanes in control early. That pitch down the middle for a strike.
I've got the Alderman shift up.
Interesting defensive arrangement or alignment for the left-handed batter, the second baseman. Now he takes a few steps back to more of a traditional location, but he was way over by the first baseman. And Alderman pops it up in the infield, but it'll be to the third base side. Moving over is the shortstop. Short left field, he'll make the play and end the inning.
For GSW in the bottom of the second, one run, three hits. There were no lander errors, two runners left on base.
So for GSW in the second, one run, three more hits, no errors, a couple left on base, two innings in the books here. GSW 2, Lander yet to score. We'll be back in a moment. So to the third inning we go in our... Kind of keeping an eye on a couple of raindrops coming down here. We're actually going to step away from the mic for just a moment as we move our video camera, which is recording today's ball game, over to our tent area. So we're stepping away from the mic for just a moment to move the camera. We'll be back in a moment. Hang with us here at Hurricane Stadium.
Barron.
So as we come back for the third inning, it was a quick one pitch, one out as Will Redding hit a deep fly ball to left field. Left fielder kept pedaling back, and just in front of the wall, and the Evan Bozoff retired jersey number in left center field made the grab, one away. Second batter was Jared Jones. First baseman took a ball and then got hit by a pitch, so that puts Jones aboard, and that gets us to our current spot with Zach Barron, the shortstop, up one out, runner on first for the Hurricanes in the third. First pitch swinging strike, 0-1. A late bunt attempt. It's gonna roll foul third base side. Barron quickly dropped a bunt on him. Somewhat of a little bit of a surprise, perhaps. I mean, I know it's a sacrifice opportunity, but Barron was taking a big hack in his first at bat, and that one was, he flashed the bunt real late as that pitch was coming in. But now he finds himself down 0-2 in the count. One away here in the bottom half of the third inning. That pitch high, ball one. One ball, two strikes. The Hurricanes shortstop, Zach Barron. Barron Barron, a redshirt senior from Woodland, Alabama, takes a ball, 2-2. Both sides. Barron turns on this one. One hops the wall, but it'll be foul.